Hello, my name is Francine Scaboria and I work at Safe Berks. Safe Berks is the local nonprofit that provides services to survivors of domestic violence and sexual assault. Our services are free, they're confidential, they're available 24 hours a day, and they're available in English, Spanish, or in any other language needed. I want to welcome our guest today. This is Marcia Graff Rowe, who is an artist. Thank you for joining us.
Well, thank you very much. Nice to be here today.
And we are here inside Safe Berks, inside the Safe House, inside a counseling room. And this beautiful art on the wall was painted by Marcia, who does this as a volunteer and has made many areas of our Safe House so beautiful. So Marcia, starting with your most recent beautiful artwork, can you tell me about this piece of work and why you chose this theme for this room?
Well, knowing that this is a counseling room and a space to use by the clients and the staff, I wanted to create something that represented a new day, a new dawn, a new chance, knowing that the clients are here to reorganize their lives and start anew. And the ocean is certainly, for many people, a place of calm and the energy that you get from the ocean waves is wonderful too, but the ocean breezes, and I just wanted to create a really comforting and calm space.
It's just absolutely beautiful, and I want to thank you on behalf of all the staff, because in addition to how much the clients appreciate it, the staff who work here really appreciate your artwork.
Well, that's a great bonus.
Yeah. And how long ago did you start volunteering as an artist here at Safe Berks?
I started February of 2018.
Okay.
I put a little note into some donations that I made here and said I'd like to paint a mural. And you had a new volunteer coordinator, Mindy, and
yes,
she jumped on that immediately. I think she was on the phone the first week of January. It's like, when you can you come in here?
Mindy was thrilled to connect with you. And great. And why do you volunteer your time to paint here at Safe Berks?
Well, I think the mission of the organization is so important, and it's just heartbreaking to, you know, imagine the circumstances of some of the women and children that are here. And I saw this building as a fortress from the outside.
Yes.
And I wanted to, as I did a tour when we talked about the very first mural, I thought it needed softening. I thought there were a lot of spaces that could bring a more homey atmosphere and the healing power of nature in an urban setting. So
it's wonderful, wonderful. We're going to talk about a few other places in this building which you have added your beautiful art to,
mm-hmm.
and then there will be adding in some footage to show you. But there is in the second floor lobby a beautiful tree, and in some beautiful shades of green. Tell me a little bit about that tree.
Well, that space is a place where staff and clients are interacting all day long. So I wanted to create something that was inspirational and use some of the messages that the women are hearing of hang on to hope and make new friends and keep growing, and you know, use these words as part of the image so that it could be an encouragement. And then I realized that the staff actually, again, sitting at the desk and looking at that mural are feeling comforted by it as well. So
it's
that
was,
again, another bonus.
Yes, it's just wonderful. And you have done amazing work, Marcia, in both of our playrooms here in the Safe House. So I wanted to talk to you first about the second floor playroom. The second floor is part of our emergency shelter, which can house up to 50 people for up to 30 days. So that room, you really added a lot of colors, some very playful monkeys. Tell me about that room and what kind of inspired you to do that.
Well, when I walked into that room, I saw the walls actually were in a pretty good shape, and they were light blue, and there were toys, colorful toys, but there was nothing on the walls for the children to really connect with. So I started by just saying, oh, I'll paint a butterfly or two, but then I got carried away and got into this whole idea of maybe a tropical rainforest, and I love painting monkeys, so then that way I have monkeys on the trees, and a toucan, and, you know, just all the wonderful animals that you'd find in a tropical rainforest. And I always hope with children's rooms that the children then can use their imagination uh-huh. and make up stories about what are these monkeys doing, and I hear that that's actually happening.
It is, and I just want to say I sometimes have the joy of reading to some children here in between my office job, and the children love that room. They love looking at the monkeys. They love finding all the different creatures kind of disguised in that tropical theme, and they just love it. And I think for the staff and for the clients, it really brightened up a long winter too. It's just been great. So then let's talk for a minute about the fourth floor playroom. Our fourth floor is our bridge housing. Up to 25 people can reside there for 3 to 6 months. This would be people who had already stayed in our emergency shelter for 30 days. So you also transformed the fourth floor playroom into sort of an underwater mm-hmm. theme.
Well, that was a suggestion of one of the clients. When I finished the first mural, she said, I would like to see something with water, underwater. And when I got up to the fourth floor, I realized that that was the room that it was really suited to do that. So you have a whole sense of being under the sea with the fishes and the seahorses and all kinds of dolphins leaping. And the children can enjoy all those things at eye level. And then I painted above the horizon a really nice sunset and seagulls and things that the moms, as they're in there playing with the children, that the mothers can appreciate the sunset. So that was nice. It was a suggestion of a client, and I was able to make it happen. And then I showed her the photos of the end results, so she was happy that her idea
it's beautiful.
Was manifested.
And now it's a permanent part of the Safe House. That's great.
Yeah.
And another room I want to ask you about is on the second floor. It's sort of a lounge area, and I like to call it the Sunflower Lounge, maybe. What was your inspiration for that area?
Well, that happened on the very first tour when I was looking for, you know, where could I start doing some painting, and I came upon this living room that was painted gray, and I thought, this has got to change. And it had a bit of a low ceiling, and it just felt so... a bit of a cave, and I thought, well, this is the first place that I know that that color and nature can really transform this, like I said, being in an urban setting. So I created a blue sky. It's always a summer day in that room.
Yes.
And because there's sofas all around, I needed to grow some flowers that were tall enough to, you know, peek up above the sofas. So sunflowers really suited that, and they're happy, cheerful flowers that always turn to face the sun and growing to, you know, their full stature. So again, I always think of the things as symbolic, that the women, you know, can rise up above their hardships and look again for a new day.
And it's also a room where I notice the children find the little bunny rabbits.
Yes,
the
there's some
squirrels,
hidden creatures.
It just makes it so fun. And then I wanted to ask if anyone wanted to contact you about their own painting project, whether it was in a residence or a business, mm-hmm. and they wanted to get in touch with you. How could they get in touch with you, Marcia?
Well, I do have a website, so it's the name MarciaGraff.com.
Wonderful. Wonderful. And one other question about your process. I guess kind of two questions. Do you sketch it out? And also, what kind of paint do you use?
A mural of this size, I would do a drawing first on just 8.5 by 11 paper, sketch it out to proportion with a pen drawing, and then usually just pencil crayons, color it in so that I figure out where I want to place the colors, and then that's something a client can look at, and then we're all knowing we're on the same page, we all have an idea of what's coming, and then when I start to paint, often you have to put a base coat on. You want a good starting point. And so we painted this whole room, actually. Got a new base coat. And then I actually sketched things out with chalk. And rough out where the ocean is. And a bit of tape to make a good straight line for the horizon.
Yes.
And And then I'm using basically Sherwin-Williams, and I will mention them because they've donated a few gallons of paint to us. So we appreciate Sherwin-Williams. And so it's very durable. I'm using house paint. And so it can be wiped off if any splashes happen or something with some coffee, you know, whatever. You know, it can be wiped off. So I'm using durable paint.
Great. Well, I just want to thank you so much for coming on the show today, but also for everything you've done to make the Safe House more beautiful for everyone who, the clients here, the staff here. It's just been great. We really appreciate it.
Well, I just want to say one last thing that I did not think about when I said I would come in here. My mother went to school right outside this window, I see Southwest, and this is the school that my mother attended, and she lived at 3rd and Franklin. And so here I find myself in this neighborhood where my mother spent her childhood.
Right.
And that has been such an amazing, again, a bonus that I did not plan on. And so I feel lots of, I don't know, tender feelings when I'm here. And I love interacting with the children and the clients and the staff who are so kind. So it's been just a great experience.
That's wonderful.
Thank you.
Well, again, we want to thank artists Marcia Graff Rowe for her work, and please check out the website for Safe Berks if you'd like more information. It's at www.safeberks.org. Thank you.